Welcome back to Upfront. Democrats are critical of the two-year spending plan that came out of joint finance last week, and they're calling it a missed opportunity. We're talking now with one of them, Representative Evan Goyke of Milwaukee, who serves on the Budget Writing Committee. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
First question for you, what should the governor do with this?
Well, the governor needs to wait and see what the Assembly and Senate does first. So it would be inaccurate to say this is a final product, because both the Assembly and the Senate need to vote on this. And we're starting to see some problems. There's some Republican senators that have been tweeting and have been saying in some interviews that they have problems with the overall level of spending that their other Republicans approved. So I think it's premature to say what the governor should do or shouldn't do, because we just don't have a final product yet.
Should he leave open the possibility of an overall veto?
Well, I think he should leave all options on the table. And it's important to know that the governor's veto in Wisconsin is incredibly broad. It's a hard question to answer yes or no at this point, because there are a lot of different options, and I think he should keep them all open.
At this point, are Democrats like yourself looking at certain provisions that you could line item or suggest to the governor to line item to get to where you'd like to be?
Well, there were three issues that define the campaign: healthcare, education, transportation. And I think that Republicans in the legislature tried to catch up to the governor's leadership on those three issues, but fell short. Not expanding Medicaid created a hole in the budget that the Republicans couldn't fill. They didn't meet the target on special education funding. And then on transportation, they increased taxes by 137% every time you buy a car, and failed to let out-of-state drivers help pay for the roads by increasing the gas tax, which they use. So I think they've missed the mark on those three big categories, and that's where I'll be watching with great detail as the budget bill goes forward.
Are you looking for specifics in terms of line item possibilities at this point?
I don't have any specifics. Right now, it's a focus on, you know, ensuring that nothing crazy happens at the last second. In the last couple of budgets, there have been substantial changes when it was just one party rule. So I'm not taking a day off. I don't have a cocktail with an umbrella in it yet, because I think there are still changes to come.
Take Medicaid expansion out of the equation, which Republicans have. Is this a good budget that you can get behind some provisions?
Well, there are certainly pieces where the governor led and said the state needs to invest in roads. And I acknowledge that Republicans in the legislature increased spending from prior Republican budgets. But I also don't accept the method in which they did. So it's not just as simple to say X number of dollars in transportation is good enough. The way we're getting there is a problem for me, too. So I don't have any specifics that I am hanging my hat on now. I'm looking at this overall and ensuring that, you know, waiting and seeing what the legislative Republicans in the Assembly and Senate do.
Are you satisfied with the health care spending increase, Medicaid expansion aside?
No. Well, you can't split the two, because Medicaid expansion allows Wisconsin taxpayers to save $324 million. Reinvested to leverage $1.6 billion in new federal funding. So I think it's a mistake, and it's irresponsible political not to do the expansion. And they did invest in some areas, but they left others out.
Are Democrats looking to make this a campaign issue, the Medicaid expansion?
It already was. Governor Evers campaigned on this in November of 2018, and he won. He said he would expand Medicaid. The voters knew what they were getting in Tony Evers. They want the expansion.
Republicans have come out and said, as you very well know, Wisconsin voters actually don't want this, and we are here to protect that.
They call it welfare, and they hide it. When polling, the Marquette University Law School poll comes back whether or not Medicaid should be expanded, over 70% are in favor. When the Republicans call it a different thing, they like to call it welfare. It's not welfare. We're talking about expanding access to health care for working people. They just don't make a lot of money. And put all that aside, call it whatever you want, it's still fiscally irresponsible not to save 300 plus million in state taxpayer money and draw down over $1 billion in federal funding.
Was there compromise in this among members of the Joint Finance Committee?
Well, the process of writing the budget in Joint Finance was not a collaborative one, and that's just the honest truth. Republicans would meet in a closed room somewhere in the Capitol. I didn't get an invite. They would come in with their final product, and then we would duke it out in the committee. So I can't say that it was collaborative. I'll say this, the last action of our committee was on a bill about how to spend out-of-state sales tax. Mm-hmm. That was collaborative. We had an amendment that was unanimous, and the bill as amended, unanimous. So we can get there when we want to, when we try.
Quickly on juvenile justice, the 115 removed to build new prisons. What's going to happen with Lincoln Hills?
I can't see anything happening other than more delay, because the Republicans on joint finance removed that money, as you said, and that's going to stall the Department of Corrections moving forward, building new, smaller, more regional alternatives for our kids. That's what we need.
A couple more weeks to go.
I'm almost done. Yeah.
State Representative Goyke, thank you so much. Next on Upfront, millions are coming to help fix state roads, but will drivers see the difference?